I've recently returned from a trip to India, where I had the pleasure of spending about 2.5 weeks exploring, looking into some opportunities there with BPOs, call centers, and basically expanding the business. And while I was there, I learned some very interesting insights that I would like to share with all of you. I'd also like to mention that we now have a training consultant in India, DK. He will be on our website if you'd like to contact him, if you're in that area or if you're interested in training in India. And while talking to him, I learned some insights for Hindi speakers. So if your first language is Hindi, I'd like to share a bit of the information and insight with all of you. Now, you'll notice with the K sound in English that it's actually sounding a little bit different than the K sound made by most Hindi speakers. And the reason for that, as DK shared with me and I learned to be true, is that the tongue touches the top of the mouth or palate, and it sounds a little bit like kick, for example, instead of the American pronunciation, which is way in the back. It's a velar sound. Kick. Notice the difference between the tongue touching the upper palate, and you can use a mirror to check location, tongue touching the upper palate, kick, and opening the mouth wider, the tip of the tongue does not rise, but the mouth merely opens wider, kick. Notice the difference in sound. Kick, kick. For American English, you want to make the k sound way in the back. Now the same is true of the g sound. Not g, but g. Way in the back. The tip of the tongue doesn't rise, the tongue comes back, the mouth opens, g, as in great. Now this can also be helpful with the R sound, because similarly, the tongue is curling back, not touching the upper palate for the R. So after you can make the K sound, it can be helpful to now make the R sound. So let's change that word kick, not kick, but kick, to rick. Make sure you're not touching the upper palate, rick. Instead, you're curling the tongue back without touching, rick. Now, it may also help you to anchor the tongue on both sides with the upper teeth and then curl the tongue back, rick, rather than rick, rick. Those are a couple of tips that I'd like to share with you. And in addition, the T and the D sounds are always challenging for Indian speakers. Remember that they are plosive. That is, the T and the D has a little bit of air. The other interesting thing about Hindi is that most sounds are voiced, at least lightly voiced. Even your T has a little bit of voicing. But the important thing to note in American English is that a word like test has no voicing on either T. Voicing meaning a buzz on the vocal folds. So if you put your hand here on your throat and say test, you should have some air t-t on your hand. You should also have no buzz here. You don't want to curl the tongue slightly behind the ridge and make a sound like test. That sound is coming from your first language and is not a truly American sound. So instead of test, you want test. Lots of air, t, but also no buzz on the T. Now on the D sound, d, like David, you're not going to curl back and go d. You're going to make a true D. David. David. Test. The same is true with the P and the B sounds. Bob has a little bit of a plosive there. B, Bob, and p, pop. Make sure you're not saying Bob or pop, but you want to actually use a bit more air. There's no voicing on the voiceless sound P. There is voicing on the B. There's no voicing on the T, as in test. There's only voicing on the D, as in David. I hope these tips have been helpful to you. I would also like to let all of you know that for the first time, we're releasing a DVD of all of the videos for our program. So many of you have contacted me out of interest for personal coaching, and perhaps you're not ready to do it yet, but you'd like to see our materials. So those of you that have been watching some of these videos and would like a complete set, a 6-hour DVD will be available on our website shortly. And I just wanted to let all of you know that, so that if you are interested, you can purchase it. I've enjoyed sharing this information and knowledge with you, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Who knows which country I'll be going to next.